Greetings, friends. It's Zera, back with another Classic WoW Hunter video. Today, we're going to be discussing the hot topic that is melee weaving. So, without any further ado, let's jump right into it. All right, here we are. This is my new design layout, but this will allow us to kind of just dump right in so we can look at the gaming content. So, as some of you might be able to see, you might be able to tell that I'm rocking Ash Candy. And, of course, Ash Candy cannot be complete without Astral Thule. All right, so the immediate thing that I know I need to do is put slap plus 15 agi on this thing. I haven't really decided if I'm going to be doing any PvP right now. Probably not, even though, like, yeah, it'd be crazy not to, right? Like, I could pretty much delete people with this combination. But moving forward, I want to just focus on melee weaving in a PvE setting. So I'm going to go ahead and slap plus 15 agility on this, probably in the next couple of days before raid on Wednesday. The thing that I really want to focus here is the fact that melee weaving does not make you a better hunter. Let's just get that out of the way. I know there's a lot of people that are going to want to go to the comment section and say, ew, you haven't been melee weaving since day one, you're a garbage hunter. Don't let people talk to you like that. It's a bunch of nonsense. Melee weaving is literally only for those individuals that, you know, want to have a little bit more of a challenge, a little bit more of a, you know, interesting time in raid. Because I'll be honest with you, not every encounter you're going to be able to melee weave. And the times you are able to melee weave, you're going to become frustrated with the fact, number one, it's a learning curve. And number two, you can still miss with melee weapons, and because you don't have melee hit cap in a lot of instances. And then also, thirdly, you're gonna have unavoidable dodges. Like, raid bosses are just gonna duck, dodge. It's gonna happen. So you have to make sure also, and here's a fourth thing too. If you really want to maximize melee weave, you gotta really put a very concentrated effort on ensuring that you have things like free action potions, Juju's Might, you know, all these different things that will buff you. For example, the melee attack power buff out of Dire Maul Tribute, that is now going to be a thing for me. So all these different things that I am going to have to now suffer through to get my hands on so that I can get the most out of this melee weave. Now, the long short of it is, melee weaving adds about 50-ish attack power, or excuse me, 50-ish DPS to your overall rotation. Now again, that is a number that I got from Six's DPS calculator. I plugged in all the variables that I have right now, and, you know, I did this, I did that, and I had this buff, don't have this buff, and it averages out to be about 50 DPS increase. Now, given the fact that, you know, we basically are going to start peaking here very soon as hunters, as far as total damage output goes, 50 DPS is a pretty big uptick. So I'm going to encourage a lot of you guys out there that are nervous about melee weaving. Believe me, I'm in the same boat. I didn't play private servers. I don't have any practice doing melee weave. But I'm fixing to jump into one particular encounter, which is probably one of the best ones to practice on, is Golemag in Molten Core. And I found some success with it. So without any further ado, let's jump right into that footage. My apologies, I actually misspoke. Apparently I don't have footage from Golemag, but the first boss encounter in Molten Core will do just fine, Lucifron. So as you can tell right now, I'm just shooting from range on the ads. I didn't really want to start. This is my very first fight with melee weaving, so this will be pretty rough. But again, it's a learning curve. It's something we're going to figure out together. So here you can see I'm just basically just unloading on the ad. There's not really any reason for me to go too ham on this. But I ended up with a problem here because the mob ended up coming onto me, and I didn't really have a choice. I just kind of had to melee weave him down, and down he goes. So in the future, I'm just going to have to be really, really careful, because now that I have things like Astral Thule and Ash Candy, Devil Star Eye, Rapid Fire, like, these are going to absolutely wreck bosses and adds and mobs. My threat is going to go through the roof, so I got to be really, really careful not to pull threat like I did just there. So that's my bad on that. So, learning curve. Like I said, Astrothule does a lot of damage. So here, I'm trying to find my base. I'm trying to find my footing. And I got a backup here. And now I'm able to... Okay, I'm in range of my auto shot. So auto shot, I'm going to throw in my aim shot here. After that, I'll do my multi-shot. I got a quick shock proc. And then I'm running here. Melee weave. He dodged it. So the macro that I have is going to make sure that you always cast Raptor Strike first. It's not going to have like a start attack, then Raptor Strike, because then you run the risk of hitting with a melee strike, which Raptor Strike is your actual melee strike. It actually substitutes for your melee strike. It's an think of it as a buffed auto attack. That's basically all Raptor Strike is. So you got to make sure that the macro that you're using always will use Raptor Strike first, which mine does. I'll put it in the description below, or you can check it out in the Discord. By the way, we have over 1,000 members in Discord officially as of this week. That is awesome. That is absolutely incredible. I'm blown away. Thank you guys so much for the support you guys are giving me. And please be sure to follow the link down below, twitch.tv@saltyzera. It'll be lovely to see you guys there and hang out and have a good time and continue to talk theory crafting for hunters, not to mention any of you Final Fantasy secret closet fans of Final Fantasy 7 Remake. Be ready for that. We got 10 days until that's released, so be looking forward to a lot of streams on that. So this is pretty much it in a nutshell. You're using your auto shot, multi-shot combo. As soon as aim shot and multi-shot are both on cooldown and you're in your window of opportunity to run in between your auto shots, while both aim shot and multi-shot are both off cooldown, you're running in, and then he dodges another Raptor Strike. So I jump back out, and then as soon as I'm back in range, boom. Didn't even clip my auto shot. My auto shot was perfectly right as soon as I got back to regular range. It went off. Channeling aim shot. But of course, he dies here. So, I mean, that's it in a nutshell. You're looking for that window. I mean, I really wish I could like back this up to perfectly show you guys. I mean, this was almost perfect execution on my part. I probably couldn't have done this any better. So I'm aim-shotting here, and then I'm multi-shotting here just before the window closes. And then here's my auto shot. I run in. Now notice the bar here is in the white, in the white, in the white, in the white. Dodges my Raptor Strike. I run back out, and then I shoot again. Almost literally no, absolutely no need for me to cast auto shot, because as soon as I get back out the range, auto shot is like ready to go again. So there's not any clipping, which is really, really great. That's the great thing about having Astrothule. And this is without me even testing the 13% quiver. And I'm not gonna lie, I'm really tempted to test out the 13% quiver probably this week. I want to see what my damage difference is gonna be. I don't know if I'm gonna use the 13% quiver right away. What I might end up doing is I'll use the 15% quiver in BWL, because there's far less fights in BWL where I can melee weave. For BWL, you're far more likely to use melee weaving in fights against Ebonrock and Flame Gore. Chromagus, you're not going to be using melee weave. You're not going to be melee weaving Fire Maul. You're probably not going to want to melee weave Broodlord because of the Blast Wave. But... And, of course, I would love to melee weave on the first boss. I'm having a brain fart. I can't remember his name now. The one with the eggs. You guys will help me out in the comment section. But anyway, he would be a great opportunity to melee weave. The problem is he dies so fast. I mean, Razorgore, that's who it is, Razorgore. Razorgore dies so fast, like, literally, he will melt in less than 30 seconds. I guess Blizzard just decided, hey, you know, when they were designing that fight, they're like, the first part of the encounter is the hard part. You get to this part, we'll just let you just blow him up. So, meh. And again, with Vale, there might be an opportunity to use it on Vale. I don't know, because Vale sounds like he has he's also got a Blast Wave, which can do a lot of damage. And my healers are already under a lot of pressure. So, I don't know. We'll have to experiment with that one and see. I don't really feel like it's necessary. There's already at least two or three bosses you can do pretty well. Melee Weaving, BWL, Molten Core, same thing. Your best bosses to melee weave on. Lucifron's a good one. Magmanar is good, but only if you've got, you know, free action potions for the fear. Golemag is an excellent choice. Ragnaros is good too, but again, only if you have free action potions to avoid the massive knockback. That about sums it up. There might be one I'm missing. Gahanus is pretty good. He's pretty good. So you just got to get in and you got to practice too. Oh, Gar's really, really good too. But instead of actually going in on Gar melee weaving, you just stand on top of his adds, shoot him, blow him up, and then just tab target, Raptor Strike the nearest add right in front of you, and it go right back to Gar. That one's a little bit more iffy because you don't want to run the risk of an add blowing up and like exploding right in your face. So, you know, to each their own. Your mileage may vary, all that other good stuff. So I'm going to give this a shot. I'm going to make a list, and I'm going to test out some various strats. I got on my boy Six the other day, and I asked him. Also, a link down below for a really great montage he did on his channel. The idea behind having hit cap for melee versus having it for ranged, whether that's going to increase your DPS or not, is kind of pointless. Because raid bosses are always going to be able to dodge unless you're guaranteed you're going to be able to hit something from the back, which is probably few and far between when that's going to be a possibility. So, because dragons, you can't really attack from behind because you got to avoid the tail, and there's AoE, and there's a whole bunch of stuff. You certainly don't want to be right in front of a mob, but usually we come in from the side and we're fine, but, you know, coming in from the side, bosses can still dodge more often than not. So there's a whole thing with their hitbox and how things work, but his thought was, you know, you're only saving yourself about maybe 5, 6, 7 DPS if you have max hit cap, because you're still going to be, like, your attacks are still going to be dodgeable. They just won't miss. And I'm like, okay, fair enough. And actually, when I did this, as you can see, Luciferon dodged everything. Dodged a whole mess. I didn't miss. He just flat dodged. So hit cap's not going to help me there. So I think I've decided that I'm not going to push for hit cap on melee. If I get it, great. With tier 1, it would probably be a lot easier to get. Matter of fact, in ZG, I probably will have melee hit cap with full tier 1, because with the ZG enchants on my head and my legs, the 1% hit from each will give me 9% hit cap with melee weapons. So I'm going to play with the numbers. I'm going to play with the DPS calculator. But as it stands right now, that's it, guys. I hope you appreciated the video. I had to reset Windows and everything on my PC, so I had to redo all my OBS scenes and everything. That's why it looks a little bit differently than it usually does. So be sure, again, to come by the stream sometime this week. I stream every Wednesday and Thursday for raids at the very least, and then I stream most of the other days of the week. Just kind of random, sporadically. Right now we're focusing on leveling in classic. We're not classic, we're leveling in retail because of the 100% XP boost. Final Fantasy VII Remake comes out in 10 days, so that's going to be a lot of fun. So be sure to come out and hang out. Alright, boys, I'll see you guys in the next video. Love you as always. It's your boy, Zera, and I'm out.